Rebecca, if a York County landowner calls you and wants you to take a look at the soil in your yard, what things would you describe?
I would describe that my yard's soil is kind of dry. It's light brown. Grass does not grow well in my yard, but there are about 15 trees. We also don't flood, so it isn't moist usually. We have a line of bushes that we have to cut every summer, so I think they grow pretty good. We have a very big playground under the swings. It's pretty moist. Downstairs, it's pretty dry.
Okay, if a York County farmer calls and wants to get some ideas about how to change from a regular farmer to a organic farmer, what steps would you suggest? Would you even recommend to use information from the websites below to form your suggestions?
I would recommend the change because you will save up to $5,000 a year on your grocery bill.
Okay, if an anonymous call comes in, which means the person does not leave his or her name, to complain about the neighbor who is having dreadful erosion problems, someone has to go out and investigate the situation. The case is assigned to you, what would you tell the landowner about correcting the problem? How would you design a simple model with correcting the problem? How would you design a simple model with tray soil and water to show the person telling him or her? For help with the model, you want to read the article of ideas, the folder. Remember, you don't have to really build the model, just be able to describe how it should be done. For actual background erosion information, use this website.
I would recommend moving because if you don't move, then your house will fall in the water.
Okay. What should you suggest to a York County resident about planting grass seeds, also known as seeding? Using pieces of grass already planted in a layer of soil called sod. Use information from the websites below to form your suggestion.
I would recommend sodding because it's weed-free at the beginning. Its disadvantages is that it's very expensive, so your final decision should be yours of choice.
After you finish preparing your answers, your teacher or other she chooses to interview a team. We'll let you know the exact date and time for your interview. You'll want to practice saying these answers out loud, not really reading word for word, but being able to remember the big ideas. After the interview, you'll find out a way out if you're hired. Good luck. You need the job. There are bills to pay.